Hi there, I'm Christopher Harrison, Senior Program Manager inside of Microsoft Cloud and AI. And now I want to turn our attention into creating an app that's going to send down some bit of data. And we're going to do this by setting up a GET route inside of our application. Now, we're going to start off by setting up a simulated little database here that's going to store our data. And obviously, this is not designed to be real world. This is just a JSON object. It's going to have a key that will be our name and then a very simple account. So we'll have the user, the currency, the balance, the description, and then our transactions here. So we've got all of that set out. And now what we want to do is to allow somebody, if they specify the name, to access the account here. So the way that we do this is we once again set up a GET route, but this time we're going to specify that it's going to look for a string literal of accounts, and then they can provide the username. And that's going to be a parameter. So we're going to be able to read this. And when we set up our function, you're going to notice that, again, there's our user. We're declaring it right there. Express is going to be able to read this, and it will make it available off of the request object. Remember, that's what the user sent up. And that will be our user. Now what we're going to do is we're going to look to see, is there an account with that user? So we'll go ahead and grab that. Because of the fact that it's an object, we can just use that name to go retrieve it. If there isn't one, what we always want to do is send down a 404, which of course is a not found. And what we're going to notice here off of that response object here, when we return this, is that we can specify our status, our 404, and then we can also add in some additional data as well. So we'll go ahead and specify a bit of JSON. Let me just clean up the formatting here. There we go. And we'll send in a very complex error message where we'll just say error and then user does not exist. If it does exist, then we just need to send down the JSON. So we'll go ahead and say return response JSON and then that account. We don't need to specify 200. That's going to be the default. A real quick save here, let it refresh, go back to our simple client. And now let's update the URL here. You're going to notice that I've already got that entered in. And now when I hit send, what we'll notice is it will give us back all of that information. You're also going to notice that if we specify a bad value like Wibble and run it, we do in fact get that 404. So we're getting this behavior that we had expected, that we had programmed. So there's our GET routes and how we can also add in a parameter. In the next video, we'll continue down this path by seeing how we could allow somebody to modify data.